The honors in political science from Guru Tegh Bahadur Khalsa College.
Yes,
Khalsa
sir.
College and Guru Tegh Bahadur Khalsa College, the same thing?
Yes.
Opposite Miranda House?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. And you done it in 2017?
Yes, sir.
So now we are in 2020.
Yes.
What are you doing since then?
Sir, preparing for civil services.
Okay. So you're talking, taking coaching somewhere? How
no,
are
sir.
You preparing?
Sir, self-study only, sir. Using
self-study.
Coaching institutes only for test series, sir.
Okay, and your subject is political science?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Aditya, please tell us something about the security concerns of the country today.
Yes, sir.
What are the security threats to our country today?
Yes, sir. Sir, the security threats are, sir, multifold, sir. Sir, as far as, sir, on the external front is concerned, sir, we have immediate threat coming from Pakistan and in medium to long term from China, sir. As China's power grows and it becomes more and more aggressive in South Asia and Indian Ocean region, sir. Temporarily, external front, sir, Pakistan is posing problems because of its sponsorship for terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir, and now it is also trying in Punjab, sir. As far as, sir, internal security is concerned, sir, we face internal security challenges in left-wing extremism, in form of left-wing extremism, insurgency in Northeast, Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab to some extent. And besides, sir, these are conventional security challenges. We also face challenges in cyber security. More and more challenges coming in outer space, sir, with development of capabilities in China for anti-satellite and satellite hijacking systems. So, sir, these are broadly the security concerns.
So, this creation of this new post of CDS, how is it going to help us in our security concerns with these countries now?
Yes, sir. Sir, basically, sir, earlier we had, sir, three services, the Army, Air Force and the Navy, acting morely in silos, morely individually. Now, sir, the post of CDS 1 will help in more and more coordination and convergence in the working of these three forces to achieve national security goals. It will lead to better formulation of national security policy, better implementation, more economy in capital acquisitions, and overall, sir, better security preparedness of India, sir.
So now,
vis-a-vis
China.
Yes,
what
sir.
Is the situation prevailing in China, and how are we being able to combat them? Have you heard about their situation, how their army is organized, and how our army is organized to counter that?
Sir, as far as, sir, organization is concerned, sir, they are morely organized into theater commands, sir.
Correct.
Having, sir, tri-services theater commands. Whereas, sir, we at present do not have those theater commands, but that is the future goal, sir. CDS is only a stepping stone to achieve that, sir.
So, coming to the theater command, what theater
yes.
do you visualize for India?
Yes, sir. Sir, one would be, sir, a Western frontier theater against Pakistan, sir. Another would be, sir, against China, sir. And one could be in the Indian Ocean region, sir, a joint command for the Indian Ocean.
So they say ki whosoever rules the wave rules the world, because as long as Britain was ruling the waves, it was number one. It was replaced by America.
Yes, sir.
Now that is ruling the waves, so that is becoming number one. It has become number one ever since then.
Yes, sir.
So whom do you see coming up, gradually creeping up and ruling the waves now?
Sir, it is.
Are we in the race at all? That is why I'm being trying. Are we in the race?
Yes, sir,
for
we
ruling
are.
Ruling the waves?
Yes, sir.
Please tell us. Who are the countries who are competing for ruling the waves today?
Yes, sir. Sir, the sea has been a very contested geopolitical space, sir. As you said, sir, who rules the sea? That power rules the world, sir. Sir, at present, sir, USA has a very powerful navy. It has fleets almost in all over the world. Sir, China is developing very fast blue navy capabilities. It is developing aircraft carriers, submarines, and all that. Sir, India also has a very clear vision, sir. Most of our resources are now being dedicated even to Navy, because we have a very clear vision to be a net security provider in the Indian Ocean region. We have an aircraft carrier from Russia, sir, Vikramaditya. We are developing our own indigenous aircraft carrier also. We are developing nuclear power submarines, and we have a joint naval command in Andaman and Nicobar, sir. So we are also, sir, in the race to, sir. Navy, though not in the immediate term, not blue navy capabilities or far off capabilities.
So what are the strengths of our navy yes. and what are our weaknesses?
Yes, sir.
What are the strength of the Indian Navy?
So the strength of the Indian Navy is one of all the geographical position we inherit, sir, being in the middle of the Indian Ocean. the very geostrategic capabilities, the geostrategic opportunities that gives the geographical position. One is that inbuilt strength of our Indian Navy, sir. Second, sir, I would say, sir, a lot of good assets we have, sir. We have advanced, like aircraft carriers, sir, nuclear-powered submarines, and in asset-wise, sir, we have good, sir. And then in research, sir, we are developing indigenous capabilities for Navy, so that is also a strength, sir. As far as, sir, weaknesses is concerned, I would say, sir, there is a finance crunch, sir. There is need for more money, more capital assets, more faster pace of defense indigenization. That would be, sir, the weakness.
Now, China says ki the biggest aircraft carrier in the world,
yes, sir,
is actually the Deccan Plateau of India. Have you heard about it or not?
Not exactly, sir.
China thinks about India, the Deccan Plateau, 7,500 kilometers of its coastline juts right into the Indian Ocean. There is no ocean in the world which is named after a country.
Yes, sir.
We are fortunate, India is fortunate, and China thinks this is the biggest aircraft carrier in the world.
Yes, sir.
Truly so. Do we require that aircraft carrier after that?
So, yes, sir. Our geographical position is really very unique and gives us a lot of strategic capability. But still, we need aircraft carriers to go deep south into the Indian Ocean or to travel into the...
Which country? There is only Antarctica to go to. And we don't visualize to go into Australia. That is, we got an alliance with Australia.
Yes, sir.
And let me give that thing to that theater to Australia and to New Zealand and to America. That Pacific Ocean we looked after by America. We are not competing with them. So let them fight it out among themselves. And the Western zone, there is no competition.
So, but sir, still aircraft carriers are required to secure, sir, the Gulf, Persian Gulf, sir, the Red Sea region, sir, the eastern coast of Africa.
The piracy issues and for that. Sir. You require frigates, you require aircraft carrier for that. Aircraft carrier, what is the strength of aircraft carrier?
But sir, when China is preparing, building military capabilities, they are building naval base in Djibouti.
Submarine based. And whatever aircraft carrier they have, they don't have the wherewithal to operate it. We are very fortunate that even though we did not make any aircraft carrier, but we operated them nevertheless. The Second World War, India was actually the crux through which the whole theater of war was conducted, whether it is air services.
Yes.
They were supplying the meeting the Japanese through the air services.
Yes.
And we were catering to their requirement. Royal Air Force was being managed and maintained by India.
Yes.
Same was the case with Navy also. And when they left that INS Vikrant to this place.
Yes, sir.
And we may not be having the ships, but we have the manpower, trained technical manpower.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Aditya. Something very life-changing happened when we won 1995 in this country. Can you recall? It has changed our life upside down. Q is that related to information technology?
Sir, in technology sector, sir.
Information technology.
Such life-changing things, sir, I do not remember.
15th August 1995, BSNL first time declared public internet.
Yes, sir.
This is the life-changing. Okay.
Yes.
In 95, two leaders were assassinated.
Yes, sir.
One is from your state.
Yes, sir.
One is international leader. Both due to terrorism.
Sir, I can recall the leader from our state, sir, Sardar Bayant Singh, sir, the Chief Minister of Punjab. But, sir, the other leader, sir, I am
our friend. It's our friend nation now, Israel. Okay. You have written your sports.
Yes.
Hobbies, you have written tennis. Lawn tennis, table tennis?
Lawn tennis, sir.
Okay, lawn tennis. Can we ask a little question?
Yes,
lawn
sir.
Tennis?
Yes, sir.
Which one is the longest match? In the long. Can it go endlessly, match? As per rule?
Sir, earlier it used to, sir, at present in French Open that is there, sir, to win the last set, sir. A player has to win two consecutive games to win that set, sir. So the match can go, sir, really long, sir. But since, sir, in other Grand Slams, a tiebreaker rule has been imposed, which varies from slam to slam, sir. Like in Wimbledon, if the set score reaches 12-12, then a tiebreaker has to be played. In US Open and in Australian Open, a tiebreaker is played only at 6-6 only, sir, to keep short the match length.
Okay. Longest match?
I do not remember exactly.
Even then Wimbledon, not very famous player. Okay, check it in. Swimming, it's a very interesting area. What do you do in swimming?
Which stroke?
Freestyle, sir.
Freestyle.
Who is the famous player who has won 28 medals in the Olympics?
Sir Michael Phelps, sir.
Why is he extraordinary?
Sir, because of, sir, I think, sir, one, obviously the skill and the technique of swimming that he has. Secondly, sir, I think he feels very, he himself says that when I go into the water, I just immerse myself in it. I just get lost and I'm too much into it, sir. So that quality of his, sir, that is also responsible for his success, sir.
You have so many, this, how do you get time for this cycling, swimming? What is this spiritual knowledge?
Yes, sir.
Something
you can tell us.
Please tell us something about spiritual knowledge.
Ask this question.
What is spiritualism?
Sir, spiritualism, sir, it actually means, sir, to try to know about the nature of life, sir, to try to understand the nature of life, sir. But very simply speaking, sir, spiritualism means to look inward, sir. Sir, since the whole experience of our life, the whole basis of our actions come from within. Spiritualism, sir, for me, I think it means, sir, to look inward, sir, to improve the quality of life, sir, and to be a better human being.
So how far have you succeeded in that?
Sir, it's an ongoing process, sir, to improve.
Have you joined any course? Is there any spiritual, so many spiritual gurus?
Yes, sir.
Could you name some of them?
Sir, as of now, sir, there are many, sir, in our country, like sir, Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev, sir, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar ji, sir, and many others also, sir.
Have you ever been to them, Ravi Shankar ji or some other person?
Sir, I have attended the inner engineering course of Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev, sir.
Inner engineering, Shambhi Mahamudra, sir. How about his feeling? How do you feel about it?
Very good, sir.
What is this Sukh Kriya which he does?
Sir, it is basically, sir, about breath, sir. Kind of pranayam, sir. Lom vilom, sir, as it's commonly called, sir.
And what is the Patanga Asana which he does in the Baba Ramdev's terminology? It is something different.
Butterfly Asana, sir.
So how is it different from butterfly stroke and butterfly Asana? Swimming, you have butterfly stroke. I think that is the toughest stroke in swimming.
Yes, sir.
This is also the toughest in the spiritualism also.
So not as tough, sir. In this, sir, it is basically to move the legs and the thighs like butterfly wings, sir. And in swimming, it is involves the mostly the whole body, sir, arms and the legs.
So which is tougher? Swimming.
I think swimming, sir.
Do you know butterfly stroke?
I know, but sir, not very proficient, sir.
So your reason for wanting to join civil services? Yes.
Ma'am, because I think I like the job of administration and governance, to be a part of managing the collective affairs of the society, to interact with all segments of society, to be at the grassroots, to implement various developmental programs and to contribute to national development.
Thank you.
ठीक है सर.
Subject आपके तैयार हैं बिल्कुल. Political science, international relations एक ही subject है शायद.
Yes sir.
तो international relations से संबंधित सवाल थोड़े से पूछे जाएंगे. Security concerns है. पहले cold war थी, अब trade war हो गई है.
Yes sir.
इसके concerns तो आपको तैयारी है. You are quite fresh. बहुत अच्छी बात. ये पहली बार interview में जा रहे हैं.
Yes sir.
Debating वाला किया है आपने कभी?
Yes sir.
किया है ना? Yes sir. तो आपको delivery और speech बता रही है कि आपका बात करने का जो कहते हैं जो दिमाग में विचार आ रहे हैं और उसकी डिलीवरी बहुत परफेक्ट है.
Yes.
कोई उसमें जरा सा भी गैप नहीं है. अभी आदमी सोचता है तो उसको एक्सप्रेस करने में टाइम लगता है. Yes. आपके साथ में कतई कमी नहीं है जो Yes. आपके दिमाग में विचार आ रहे हैं. व्हाट ट्रेवल्स फास्टर देन लाइट इज अ थॉट.
Yes.
थॉट ट्रेवल्स इवन फास्टर देन लाइट.
Yes.
तो योर थिंकिंग प्रोसेस बीइंग डिलीवर्ड इन अ परफेक्ट सिंक्रोनाइजेशन इटसेल्फ इज अ टास्क.
Yes.
So you are very good at that. आपका हर चीज़ तरीके से कमी है. You will do very well in it.
Yes.
Do all the best.
Thank you.
CAA. हाँ, CAA के बारे में सवाल पूछा नहीं, ये सवाल अमूमन पूछा जाता है. CAA, NPR और NRC.
Yes.
इन दोनों के बीच में आपको अंतर मालूम होगा.
Yes sir.
क्या है अंतर? CAA citizenship देता है.
Yes sir.
NPR National Population Register, वो क्या है?
सर पॉपुलेशन जो यूजुअल रेजिडेंट सेकेंडरी
उसका बेसिस क्या होता है?
सिटीजनशिप एक्ट ही है सर उसका बेसिस.
नहीं, सिटीज एक्ट नहीं है, नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर इज बेसिकली पॉपुलेशन ऑफ द कंट्री एग्जिस्टिंग एट अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम एंड पॉपुलेशन एग्जिस्ट एट अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम एज पर द सेंसस 2011 में जो सेंसस हुआ था उसके बाद उसी के ऊपर नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर बना है 2014-15 में अपडेट हुआ है. तो बेसिस फॉर नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर जो सेंसस हाउस होल्ड जानते हो जब सेंसस होता है उसके लिए आप हाउस लिस्टिंग करते हो. हाउस लिस्टिंग के बाद हाउस टू हाउस सर्वे होता है, फिर आप सबका पूरा का पूरा सेंसस लेते हो. सेंसस में आपको माइग्रेशन पॉपुलेशन सब होती है. तो पॉपुलेशन एग्जिस्टिंग एट अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम इज द सेंसस फिगर एंड नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर इज ऑल्सो एज पर द सेंसस कमिटी के ऊपर नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर बन जाता है. तो नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर है दे माइट बी अ सिटीजन ही मे नॉट बी अ सिटीजन. तब जब नेशनल रजिस्टर सिटीजनशिप बनेगा तो फिर वो उसका बेसिस होगा. जैसे आप नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर पर जाओगे तो उसका बेसिस होगा सेंसस. जब सिटीजनशिप का रजिस्टर बनाओगे उसका बेसिस होगा नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर. ये तीनों चीज़ें पूरी एक्सरसाइज कहाँ हो चुकी है? असम में. अकॉर्ड के थ्रू हुआ था 71 वाज़ द कट ऑफ डेट. कंट्री के लिए कट ऑफ डेट कौन सी होगी? 1947 50 दिया था ना कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन लागू हुआ था सिटीजनशिप एक्ट आपका लागू होता है. उसमें वो कट ऑफ डेट वो है. लेकिन अब उसके लिए जो आपका CAA है वो 2014 कर दिया है. उससे डिस्क्रिपेंसी इसलिए हो रही है क्योंकि वहाँ पर 71 असम अकॉर्ड बनाए बैठे हैं. वो देश के लिए तो 2014 लागू कर दो बात समय आएगा. वो सब चीज़ें फ्यूचर में है. ये सवाल पूछा जाएगा. अब पूछने में ये वैलिड है कि नहीं है वैलिड ये सवाल पूछा जाएगा. उसमें आप क्लियरली बता देना कि भैया एक स्टैंडिंग कमेटी की रिपोर्ट थी, उस स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ने ये कहा है. आप अपना व्यू ना लगाना उसमें.
ठीक है,
उन्होंने कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन है कमेटी तो ये कह रही है साहब. अब सही है गलत सुप्रीम कोर्ट को तय कर लेने भैया मैं क्या रेफरेंस करूँ. इसे अपने को ना कमिट करना. गवर्नमेंट के प्रो गवर्नमेंट हो क्योंकि जे इन्हें कोई ले रहा है जो सवाल अच्छा खासा मैसा पढ़ा दे माइट ट्राई एंड या तो सवाल पूछा ही नहीं कॉन्ट्रोवर्स हो जाता है. अगर पूछ लिया तो तुम्हें नहीं फंसना है उसमें. आप किसने क्या कमेटी ने क्या कहा है स्टैंडिंग कमेटी की रिपोर्ट देख लेना.
उन्होंने रिकमेंड किया
है, उन्होंने कहा कि ये वैलिड है इट कैन बी. वो देखते हैं ना एग्जामिन करने के लिए. अगर आपका पास कोई उद्देश्य है उस उद्देश्य को पूरा करने के लिए आपने कोई नेक्सस एस्टैब्लिश कर दिया है तो एक्ट उसके हिसाब से वैलिड माना जाता है. यहाँ पर आपका माइनॉरिटी है. माइनॉरिटी को जो है रिलीफ देने के लिए कर रही हो तो माइनॉरिटी वहाँ तो होगी नहीं जहाँ मुसलमान कंट्री है. वहाँ माइनॉरिटी मुसलमान थोड़ी ना हो जाएगा. स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ने पाया कि भैया माइनॉरिटी को आप दे रहे हो और माइनॉरिटी वहाँ पर मुसलमान हो नहीं सकता उन देशों में. हिंदू मुसलमान के चक्कर में पढ़ना ही नहीं. स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ने क्या कहा बता दो. उद्देश्य को पूरा करने के लिए हो गया उसने करा है वो कहता ही हो सकता है. अब नाउ इट इज बिफोर द सुप्रीम कोर्ट एपेक्स कोर्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. I can't express my view. Yeah, yes, you have chat, so you will know how to.
Okay.
Anything else? Any question in your mind?
No, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Thank you.